Welcome to rygurukul.com. In this video, we'll discuss about how to create test repository into Jira X-Ray. So here we have started with X-Ray playlist. And if you want to learn about complete X-Ray in detail, then please watch my complete X-Ray playlist. So in this video, we'll cover the test repository, which enables a hierarchical organization's test at the project level by allowing us to organize test in folder and subfolder. Always keep in mind that each project has its own test repository and that a test can only belong to one folder within the test repository. This is a different approach from the traditional way of organizing tests in a flat list by using test sets. Users coming from legacy test management tools may find this approach more natural and intuitive. Other organizations may prefer to not use this feature at all and choose to the test set approach instead. So we'll see here in detail how to create and manage test repository in X-Ray Jira. For creating a test repository, simply we have to go back to testing boards where our X-Ray add-ons are installed. The test repository is master detail view, the master view on the left side. So here we have repository available. Inside the testing board, we have this options. So now you can see this is a repository. If I want to create a new repository, simply I will click on plus icon, and then we have this organization's R details are available. So let's say I want to create a test repository for retail domain application on create, and we have this repository available. If you want to create again one more folder, so probably I will select this item and click on create. So here I want to add Flipkart test cases. So we'll store here Flipkart test case. Now you can see this repository is in created successfully. At the root of the test repository, we'll see the test repository folder. This folder has the following characteristics. It corresponds to the root folder, is read-only, meaning it can't be deleted or renamed. After that, whatever folders will create it, that is possible to delete and rename it. Carefully structure the hierarchy of the folder, keeping in mind that a test may only be a single folder. How would we organize them on the laptop if we have dealing with the documents? Start by identifying the folders that we want to place at the root, and then try to drill down and create subfolders that are relevant to us. If we are already using test sets, don't try to replicate the test sets model in the test repository, because most likely it won't work again. A test can only be a part of that folder in the test repository. So once we'll select this test repository, we have all these options are available. After that, we can add a create test set. So here we can select any of the test cases, whichever we want to add inside this folder. Click on add selected, and we have this details are available. Add test. So here we'll select this one and click on add selected. Because these datas are already available, we can also create a test. When we are creating test, we can just add test demo 4. And now we have this test data are available. So this test repository gives a CRUD operation, that is create, read, update, and delete. Actions to be selected folder, create, rename, delete, and update. So can be assessed by right clicking on this folder. Here we can create a test, adding a test. We can also rename the folder, create the folder, and delete the folder whenever it is required. So let's say I want to delete this folder. I will simply click on delete folder, and this data or the folder will be removed from my test repository. Even we can see the test sections, the complete path of the folder. We can also have filters for the test. Whenever it is required, we can apply the filter and we have the selected items are available whenever it is required. We can also switch to flat view where we can see the flat or hierarchical view, which we can choose between traditional or hierarchical folder view or flattened view. So if I want to have a look about flat view, we will see here, and switch to folder view, we can see it here. If we choose folder view, then in the test sections, we will see just the tests that are direct children of the folder selected in the left side within the folder sections. In this case, we can only select tests directly within the currently selected folder. On the other hand, if we prefer to select flat view, we will see on the right side all the tests that belongs to the other folder, related subfolder, grouped by folder. Then we can apply the filter if we want select some of the tests and do an operations for them. Folder actions, we can see it completely here. Whichever detail is available, we can see it here. Renaming the folder, updating the folder, even reviewing. Even if we want to delete the folder, we can delete it. We can expand or squeeze this folder structures by just clicking on this icon. And even we have collapse options are available. So if we will click on collapse, all this field will be collapsed together. We can also view the issues data whenever it is required. So here we have view issues. So whichever issues is available, we can see it under that folder. Now moving to another folder is also options available, where we want to move from any folder to the other folder. Ordering and changing the ranking is very much easy. We can just drag and drop and the ranking will be changed immediately. If you want to create a test, as I said, we can create a test, update the test, rename, and any options we can perform it. Even we can create test executions, whichever is required to add test execution field. So this is how we can create a test repository. Under that, we can also create a test plan whenever this will be needed. So here, add to test sets and add to test plan. That is also very much possible. Just click on yes, and this data will be added successfully into R1.0. So this is how we can add this detail. Now, if I want to go back to test plan and see the results, we have this data is available under R1.0. Now we can see retail folder is also available here. So this is how we can add tests to existing test plan using all the tests in the given folder and its descendant folder. We can also add test cases, test actions, whichever is required, we can add it quickly. Now here we have two test cases. If we want to move to the root folder, we can also perform it. The root folder, creating test set with test, we can also do it. Create test plan with this test case, and generating a document is also very much possible in Jira Axery. So that's all about test repository in Jira Axery. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so, this will be useful. Don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.